with Chief Pat Hines. Can you give us an update what the latest is right now?
Sure. Right now, the fire has been contained to the original fire building and the various additions associated with the original fire building. We're in a containment mode right now, hitting the hot spots and making sure the fire stays contained in the original fire building. We'll be operating in that mode for several hours, probably well into tomorrow. We have ground monitor devices and aerial devices hitting the hot spots on the fire. Due to the nature of construction of the building, the heavy timber construction, there's a large volume of material currently involved in the fire, so it's going to take a long-term effort to provide fire suppression.
How many fires do you currently have on fighting the fire right now?
There's approximately 150. I don't have an exact number, but approximately 150 firefighters on
them. And they're
rotating out right now due to the weather conditions and the long-term part of the fire. We are rotating crews out and freeing up equipment as we can. We have numerous pieces of equipment filling in stations throughout the county, so we're trying to relieve them also.
And how many, any injuries?
There's no injuries yet, no.
Okay, thank God. And how many counties are part of this right now?
Just all units are operating now from Orange County. We have 15 companies on the scene and numerous mutual aid companies standing by in various fire stations.
Okay, thank you very much. You were here earlier. Can you describe what it was like?
We came down 32 and we just saw the black smoke pouring from the sky. As we got closer to the neighborhood up above, it was just a cloud of smoke. Came up over here and you could just see the smoke and the flame miles away.
And were you able to smell it also?
Oh yeah, very, very strong smell.
Is this the worst we've ever seen?
In my time, yeah. I mean, the last fire that's ever been remotely close to this is James Bray, that was back in the 90s.